that they don't understand. And the blood flows from his side. How can you refuse him now? How can you refuse him now? How can you turn away from his side?
Yeah. Beautiful shore. Sweet by and by. We shall be on that beautiful shore. Just we shall be on that beautiful shore. Just we.
Bless you. Exactly.
Yes. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a big old hand.
That's right.
You know, I was, me and brother back there, we was in my little building there last night, was working and stuff, and we was putting some pins in some piston rods.
Uh-huh.
We done the first one, oh, we got it off. We sat there and I got that thing good and hot, brother Johnny. Just a few seconds before I was ready to put it down to put the pin through on the piston. So Brother Fred, I said, pray. He started praying. We slid her in there and the machine shop couldn't do no better. You know, it don't matter what it is, God will help you.
Yeah.
He'll guide your hand, he'll help you.
Yeah.
You know, I told the brother, I said, we'll make use of this bill now, but it's up for repo. I said, you know, I've got behind on my bills. After I'm a wife backwards and forwards and everything, how many knows God's good?
Amen.
The bill was up for me, so I told you. I had a little bit of money. I told her, I said, send it to them. See what they would do. They sent it to them.
Right.
I was up there, I think, three and a half months, something like that behind. She sent them the payment and glory to God. Half of a month, I'm caught up. Tell me God. God will put it in your life no matter what it is.
Yeah.
How big your problem or how small your problem is, God's still God.
Amen.
We sit there and I got that thing good and hot, brother Johnny. Just a few seconds before I was ready to put it down to put the pins through on the piston. So Brother Fred, I said, pray.
Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Yeah,
man. Come on. Yeah. Come on, the I said, we'll make it to the first time.
I'm not
walk on faces, back in the hill, chill off, Lord God. Just like that, Brother Johnny, it was healed, hey, Lord God. Just like that, Lord God, I was running. I was jumping on some river, power of God comes down, Lord God. If you're sick, friend, you feel that power of God, Lord, obey it, Lord God. He will take care of you, Lord God. Put that on foot. I was just sharing my own faces. And glory to God.
Glory.
I was running up and down them aisles. I was a jumping. I was a shouting. I was a praising my God. My old boy comes through the door. He said, the whole back of his heels, John, glory to God. And here I am running, jumping, and shouting on that foot, glory to God. No, the foot has never gave me a problem since I walked out of there, glory to God. And I wore my heels, glory to God. Just don't fight, glory to God. I will. God's good, amen. Just like that, Lord God, I was running. I was jumping on some river, power of God comes down, Lord God. If you're sick, friend, you feel that power of God, Lord, obey it, Lord God. He will take care of you, Lord God. Put that on foot. I was just sharing my own faith. Lord,
one by man. Hallelujah.
Be stoned, but what says that? This they said, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down with his finger, wrote on the ground as though he heard them all over. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, he that is without sin, let
down on the ground. Which heard it begin to be convinced by their own conscience without warning by way, beginning at the eldest even to the last. And Jesus was left alone and on the stairway to miss the first verse. And Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman. And he said unto her, Woman, where are those thine accusers? Hath no man been given
thee? Ascribe to the Pharisees.
She said, No man, Lord. For Jesus said unto her, Enter to occupancy, go and sin no more. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your precious word. I ask you to anoint me to rest upon it tonight, Lord. I want to bring glory to your name, Lord. I want to bring honor to your name, Lord. Help us to declare your gospel the way you have declared it tonight, Lord. And I give you all the glory and all the honor in Jesus' mighty name.
Wrote on the ground as though he heard it
wrong. You know, these so the scribes and Pharisees, the church of Christ, they put this woman in the very act of adultery. And they brought her before the Lord, asking him what they should do and telling him what the law of Moses said to do and so forth. And you know, he stoops down and he wrote on the ground.
And they kept on.
And so he finally told them, said, Ye without sin cast the first stone at her. So from the elders on down, one by one, they left.
For Jesus said unto her,
Go and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the I want to bring glory to you.
Ask
her where her accusers were. When he lifted himself up and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, Woman, where are those thy accusers? Hath no man condemned thee? See, they all had left because they know themselves that they had sin in their life. And they couldn't, glory to God, with an honest, clear conscience, take and throw a stone at. You never know. But glory to God, they might have been to church a bunch, but they may have been with one of them, may have been with her last week or the night before. But glory to God, that's just the way it goes. Amen. Hallelujah. But they was ready. They were ready to stone her to death until Jesus said,
Ye without sin, cast the first stone.
I got two parts in this message I want to get at tonight. On down, one by one. One is we got to have mercy on people. The Bible says those that give mercy receive mercy. We got to have mercy on people. We got to forgive people. And I can't condemn you, Stacy, in my house, amen. Come on.
When he lifted himself up and saw
you can't condemn me.
Woman, where
your house is not a door. Somewhere down the line, we have slipped somewhere, but by the grace of the Almighty God, we got forgiveness of our sins, amen.
With an honest, clear conscience, they can throw a stone at.
So what I'd like to get at, glory to God, they're not trying to destroy them, but they're just bringing them to Jesus. The first was they didn't know that they were in the will of God.
But they was ready.
When they brought that, they were
ready to stone her to death.
Until Jesus said, because they brought her
ye without sin
to the master.
I got two parts in this message.
They brought her to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. They brought her to the one that can help her sin, sick soul.
The Bible says
that their intentions were wrong.
Give mercy.
Even though their intentions was they're trying to trap him up, trying to find something.
We gotta have mercy
use him with.
But we gotta forgive.
But God used it. And Jesus said what he said, what frustration. But you notice when he called the woman.
Come on.
After he told her, you can't condemn me. He said, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw them, but the woman,
somewhere down the line, we have slipped.
But by the grace of the Almighty God, we got forgiveness of our sins. Amen.
I condemn them.
But they were ready. when they brought that woman ready to stone her to death.
Until Jesus says,
when God saves us, He don't save us.
I got two problems.
They brought her to try to put one foot in the world.
They brought her to
one in the church. There's no healthy
her sin.
I'm going to tell you something tonight, folks. Either you're saved or you're lost. Either you're living for Jesus or you ain't living for Jesus. Come on, man. He said that we be lukewarm, He'll spew us out of His mouth. See, Lord God, He told her to go and sin no more. God didn't save us so we could go and do our own little thing. Amen. He saved us so we could glorify God, bring glory to His name. If you are willfully sinning tonight, if you're willfully doing wrong tonight, if you're out drinking, if you're out popping pills, if you're out committing adultery, if you're out committing a fornication, all these things, you are willfully sinning. I'm trying to talk to people, glory to God, that's supposed to know Jesus. That's supposed to be born again. That's supposed to be walking with Him. That's what I'm talking about. The lost man does what the lost man knows to do, and that's to see.
I'm going to tell you something tonight, folks. If you're saved or you're lost, either you're living for Jesus or you ain't living for Jesus.
Come on, man. He said that we'd be lukewarm, He'll spew us out of His mouth. See, Lord God, He told her to go and sin no more. God didn't save us so we could go and do our own little thing. Amen. He saved us so we could go to God, bring glory to His name. But if you are willfully sinning tonight, if you're willfully doing wrong tonight,
if you're out, you're out.
If you're out popping pills, if you're out committing adultery, if you're out committing fornication, all these things, you are willfully sinning. If you go out and you can sin like the devil, something's wrong. If you can go out and live like the devil, come on now. Pop your pills, sell your pills, drink your alcohol, do your job, just do your fornication. Where does it try to put all these ones? That's wrong. Because the Bible says when I was born again, I became a new creature. Old things have passed away. Look, Lord, behold, all things have become new. I'm not who I was before I came to Jesus. I'm not that same man no more. I'm a new creature.
Because the Bible says you're a Christian. Lord of God, we got to get this in, and we're going to make it. you, folks. Oh, I'll never play it tonight, but it's my job to tell you, if you're in sin, you need to repent. Good God, you need to repent.
Don't play your shit.
I'm not here to come
get
you. But I'm here to tell you, get right.
Come on, get up.
Get right. Get right.
God, you'll be with him. But if you're sinning willfully, let me tell you something.
You're walking on some dangerous ground. You must to die tonight. Lord God, you open your eyes up in hell if you're out with sin and sinning against God. Amen. Come on now. You feel God dealing with you tonight. Come on, you got to let it go. Whatever it is, lay it at the master's feet and ask God to forgive you tonight. Amen. So that you can go on to do a work for Him and be with Him if He calls you out of this world. Lord God, you all in your lives up in hell and you're out with us sinning against God. Amen. Come on now. You feel God dealing with you tonight. Come on, you got to let it go. Whatever it is, lay it at the master's feet and ask God to forgive you tonight. Amen. So that you can go on to do a work for Him and be with Him and be out of all this world.
You're ruined, my God. All the sickness, all the pain, Lord, we're going to all tonight.
Going hard. This is real.
Huh?
This is real tonight. And if God's dealing with you, that's real. And it's serious. He said that his spirit will not always strive with flesh, with man. It will not always strive with man. I will see you hit that brick wall. Precious. God, let me tell you something. There is a line that a body can cross, Brother John. I don't know where it's at, but it's out there. So they turn them over to the rest of the line, and they believe a lie. And be dead. So there is a line to be crossed. This ain't no game tonight. This is real. Who could refuse him? This is real tonight. If you feel it dealing with your heart, don't push him away. If you feel it, that's real. If you feel him jogging, don't push him. I'm not trying to drag us out. I believe God's dealing with somebody tonight. Lord God, if you feel that tonight, you need to come on up. Amen. Lord God, you can talk about this preacher, laugh at me, whatever, after all you want to. But let me tell you something. When there's a soul in the balance, we got to go in for war, brother. When there's a soul in the balance, Lord God, we can't hold back. So do you hear what I'm saying? If God's dealing with you tonight, if he's drawing you tonight, Lord God, you need to come on up. You might say, well, I got saved when I was 10 years old. But yeah, but Lord God, you backslid back out into the world too. You need to come up and get your heart back turned tonight. You need to come up and cry out to him tonight. Amen. I'll say my job. Don't come back out in the world. If I die in that shame, back what the hell?
This is real.
Who could refuse me? Come on now.
This is real.
If you feel it dealing with your heart, don't push the wife. That's real. If you feel it jogging, don't push me. I'm not trying to drag us out. I believe God's dealing with somebody tonight. Lord God, if you feel that tonight, you need to come on up. Amen. Lord God, you can talk about this preacher, laugh at me, whatever, after all you want to. But let me tell you something. When there's a soul in the balance, we got to go in for war, brother. When there's a soul in the balance, Lord God, we can't hold back. So do you hear what I'm saying? If God's still with you tonight, if he's drawing you tonight, Lord God, you need to come on up. You might say, well, I got saved when I was 10 years old. But yeah, but Lord God, you backslid back out into the world too. You need to come up and get your heart back turned tonight. You need to come up and cry out to him tonight. Amen.
That's a doctor straight out of hell. He was a lamb without spot, without blemish. Come on now, do you hear what I'm saying? He was an ultimate sacrifice to end all sacrifices for sin. Come on now. Hey, tell the thief on the cross and say, that shall be with me.
I'm not trying to drag us out. I believe God's still with somebody.
God,
if you feel that tonight, you need to come on up. Amen. Lord God, you can talk about this preacher like that and whatever at all you want to. But let me tell you something. When there's a stone in the balance, we got to go into war, brother. When there's a stone in the balance, Lord God, we can't hold back. So do you hear what I'm saying? If God's still with you tonight, if he's drawing you tonight, Lord God, you need to come on up. You might say, well, I got saved when I was 10 years old. But yeah, but Lord God, you're back straight back out into the world, too. You need to come up.
He brought it up without
very public preacher without love.
Come on, if you hear what I'm saying, he was an ultimate sacrifice. He in all sacrifices.
Verses back here. But please.